It's time for some truth. I used to be a terrible procrastinator. I failed my chemistry degree the first time around. I got sacked from my first sales job, and I used to let people down all the time because I'd procrastinate on what I'd promise I would do for them. But today I am motivated. I'm more productive than ever, and I've built a seven-figure sales training business on the back of it. And do you want to know what's changed? Well, I killed my lizard brain, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can do it too, and you can get a shitload more done in your small business at the same time. Hi, my name is Will, and I make small businesses more profitable. Now, today's video is all about your brain, or at least one part of it, the part of it that's holding you back from being productive and a successful small business owner. So first off, we're going to cover that part of the brain, and we call it the lizard brain. We're going to look at where it comes from and how it still, to this very day, influences an astounding amount of your thinking. After that, we're going to get into taking action. What can you do about the lizard brain? And whilst we're often driven by our biology, I'm going to show you a way that you can smash right through it so you're not trapped by it. Then we're going to cover four techniques to making it easier to achieve the goals and reduce your levels of procrastination. We're going to look at painting a picture, then reducing overwhelm, and then the value of destruction. And finally, last but not least, we're going to cover the 5-minute rule as well. So are you ready to destroy your lizard brain like I have? Well, let's do it. Now, our brains are an amazing thing. There are around 100 billion neurons in the average head, and those neurons create around 100 trillion interconnections. That 3-pound organ in your skull is literally the most complex biological thing that we know of in the entire universe. And yet, despite how amazing the human brain is, it can still be hacked and hijacked. Sources of instant gratification, like sugar, fast food, or high-speed internet porn, can revert your mind from the human side of things that gets stuff done into what I call the lizard brain. And when the lizard brain is active, you're going to procrastinate, you're going to put off your goals, you're going to be drawn to the couch rather than to the treadmill or to the laptop to build your small business. But luckily for all of us, there is a way out. You just got to put in a little bit of work, and that's what we're going to cover in this video. So let's begin. Let's answer the obvious question. What the heck is the lizard brain, and why is it there in the first place? Well, the lizard brain is part of your brain that's left over from when we were pre-humans. It's the other side of you. It's the primitive, the non-rational, the completely self-interested, the stuck in the now version of you. And it doesn't really think in the traditional sense. It just reacts to things. Now, the problem is our logical, more advanced human brain, well, it wants to complete tasks. And if there isn't a clear pathway to completing those said tasks, that's when our lizard brain kicks in. It hijacks everything. And when the lizard brain is faced with an obstacle, it only has two options. It has fight or it has flight. And since you can't really fight an abstract goal like increasing revenue this quarter, you're stuck with the flight response. And so what do? You procrastinate. You run away from even starting that task, and those big, lofty, audacious goals that drive business growth, well, they get put on the back burner. In the end, your human brain maybe does come back online, but rather than retaking control, it comes up with ways to justify the lizard brain decision to just do nothing and procrastinate. You find new distractions. You tell yourself excuses, and you don't get any shit done. So that leads us to the all-important question. What can you actually do about your lizard brain? Well, as it turns out, you can counteract this switch. You can keep your human brain on board and stop procrastinating from this moment for good. All you gotta do is leverage these four techniques that we're gonna run through in this video. First off, I want you to start painting a picture. So to push through your lizard brain's takeover when you're thinking about a goal, you need motivation, because there's always gonna be part of you that will take the path of least resistance, or in this case, avoiding the work and never getting started. So we need a reward. We need a carrot on a stick dangling in front of you so that we start to put the wheels in motion. So instead of focusing on the difficulty of a task, imagine the end result instead. How exactly is all the hard work that you put into your small business going to pay off? What kind of benefits will achieving this task bring you? And how is your life, and how is your business, and then your life going to be better, bigger, different because of it? The trick here is to get really detailed. And I mean like really detailed. What will having an extra $50,000 a month coming into your business look like? What will you be able to accomplish with 25% more revenue or 25% more customers this quarter? How will that new strategic partnership, if you get it nailed, how will that change your day-to-day in your business? Write this stuff down. If you're procrastinating, write down the benefits that you might see if you accomplish this big goal. And really dive into the rewards here, because the clearer that you can imagine it, the more motivated you're going to be to get started, and the easier it's going to be to push past those impulses that come from the lizard brain. Next up, you've got to reduce overload. So we like to think, and this seems somewhat logical, that the more choices we have, the better off we're going to be, right? Well, it actually turns out the opposite is usually true. Psychologists call this choice paralysis, and it's a major, major hindrance to productivity. According to a study from EpiServer, 46% of customers failed to complete an online purchase specifically because they were overwhelmed by the number of choices that a vendor put in front of them. If you're in e-commerce or you have an online business, just think about losing 46% of your potential sales, all because you want to have 8 different SKUs, 16 different products in 3 different colors when the customer only really wants 3. And so when you're looking at a long-term goal and you're juggling 10 different ways to achieve it, well, you're 10 times less likely to get started than if you just put the blinkers on, narrow your focus, and head towards the goal with one clear pathway. Limit your options here. Cut down on choices. Just get started. Don't worry too much about making the right choice here. You can always pivot. You can always change directions later on once you get feedback from your customers, the market, or whatever problem you're trying to solve. But the important thing here is just to get moving. Technique number 3 to destroy your lizard brain is called the value of destruction. And this one's important because big, lofty goals can be intimidating, and they can make it, well, feel difficult, if not impossible, to start just chipping away at them. But this is just a trick by your lizard brain. Most of these big goals aren't actually that big. I find that the goals I set 10 years ago, I look at them now and I could do this in a week. Why did it take me 6 months to do that? And I'm sure 10 years from now, I'll look back at what I think is a big, hairy, audacious goal that I'm trying to achieve in this moment, and I'll be like, that was just small fry. And this goes on in a cycle over and over and over. So what you think is a big goal might not be that big of a goal in reality once you've got a bit more experience, when you're on the other side of it. So how do we then reduce the perceived size of these tasks? Because obviously we don't have hindsight. We don't have a time machine to look back on what we're doing right now and make some assumptions and change some assumptions. How do we make them seem more manageable? Well, we do that by breaking them down into smaller chunks. Set up a series of waypoints, smaller tasks, that when they add together, completes your larger, seemingly audacious task. On one hand, breaking down your lofty goals is gonna help you stay motivated. But beyond that, setting up waypoints is gonna let you stay on the right track towards completing them, because you're gonna be able to chart your progress. You're gonna know if you've moved forward from day to day to day, as opposed to hoping that you've moved forward over the course of the past 6 months. That means that you can make realistic estimated time of arrivals. You can even spot obstacles that might slow you down ahead of time. So next time you're facing a seemingly impossible goal, get destructive and start breaking it down into smaller tasks. Which leads us on to the final point in this video, the 5-minute rule. Now, this is one of my absolute favorites. I coach profitable small business owners on this all of the time, even though it sounds childish, right? But it's so effective. Let me frame this up. 5 minutes is absolutely nothing, right? It's a tiny amount of time. Do you agree with that? Well, most people can withstand pretty much anything for 5 minutes. Most people could run for 5 minutes on a treadmill. They could talk to their neighbor that they actually really despise and hate for 5 minutes. They could even listen to a freaking Justin Bieber song for just 5 minutes without throwing up in their mouth. Well, next time you're hit with a procrastination pang, just commit to doing 5 minutes of the task. That's absolutely nothing, right? Now, as it turns out, killing your lizard brain and getting started is typically the hardest part of doing the task altogether. Tasks get pretty simple once you get past that initial phase of momentum that's required to get started. Once you get past that, you're much, much more likely to carry on, and then you can keep building this momentum and this steam as you get more and more of the job finished. So if you're like me and you're really not looking forward to doing that bookkeeping and the accounts this quarter, just do it for 5 minutes. Are you dreading starting to do some cold calling, to picking up the phone and finding new customers? Spend 5 minutes doing it. If you don't want to go for that run, just walk for 5 minutes instead. You might be surprised how quickly you get the motivation that you need to keep going and get the job done. So if you're looking for the reason that you're not being as productive as what you know you should be, look to your lizard brain. And remember, your lizard brain is what takes over when there isn't a clear pathway to completing a task. It kicks in either fight or flight, and obviously you can't fight a random goal like doubling revenue, and so it turns to flight instead, and you procrastinate like hell. But the good thing is, you can do something about this. We're not trapped by our biology, and there are four ways that you can break through this. First off, paint a picture, reduce, overload, deconstruct your goal, and then lean into the 5-minute rule as well. I know it sounds childish, the 5-minute rule, but it really, really works. With that, you're gonna have kicked the crap out of your lizard brain in no time, and you're gonna get more stuff done without all the procrastination. And there we go. If you enjoyed this video, why not click the video that's on the screen right now and continue making your small business more profitable?